effective interest rate, on the other hand, comes into the picture when the interests are being compounded. So the interests are being compounded when it involves more than one compounding period. In order for us to understand better the concept of effective nominal rate, let us look into how we can illustrate the compound period. Okay, every time you see the term yearly, it means that the block covers the whole year, okay, until month 12 for 1 year. Every time you see biannually, okay, the compound period is divided into two. You just simply divide the block into two equal regions. So it is being divided into 6 months equally. Every time you see quarterly, maksudnya dalam satu tahun tu, it divided into four sections, four equal sections. So quarterly means every 3 months. Okay, let's look at this example. In this example, the interest rate is 12% per year compounded quarterly. So if we illustrate the situation in a timeline, so we will draw the timeline for 1 year or 12 months. The 12% interest rate, it covers for the whole first 12 months or the whole year. Okay. When you see the term compounded quarterly, you can visualize that the compound period for 1 year is being divided into four equal regions. So the compound period would be every 3 months. So the block here represents the compound period. So if you want to know how many interest rate represent each block, or each compound period, we divide with how many blocks there is. So in this case, if there is 4 blocks, 12% divided with 4 blocks, so each block would represent an interest of 3%. Let's look at some terminologies. Okay, nominal interest rate in this case is 12% for 1 year. What is the compounding period? You see, it is being compounded quarterly. So the compounding period is quarterly. So what is the compound frequency? Okay, how many blocks are there? 4 blocks. So the compounding frequency would be 4. What is the interest rate for each compound period? So 12 divided with how many blocks there are? 4 blocks. So each block represents the interest rate of 3%. In this case, if the question asks what is the interest rate semi-annually, we can kind of imagine that semi-annual period would look something like this. Maybe you would think that the interest rate can simply be calculated by adding up the interest rate which was represented for each block, which is 3% plus another 3%, becomes 6%. But no, my dear, no. This is when effective interest rate comes into the picture. In this case, this is an example of the interest being compounded, meaning more than one block exists in that particular timeline. So in this case, there's 2 blocks. So instead of having just simply 6% of interest rate, the interest are being compounded. The same goes if the question asks, what is the interest rate annually? So you cannot simply add on 3% plus 3% plus 3% plus 3% to become 12%. That is the nominal interest rate. In this case, when there are 4 compound period involved, then there are special formula that you should follow to get the equivalent effective interest rate. So this is the formula of the effective interest rate. The I in the equation represents the interest rate for each compound period. In this case, it will be 3%. The M represents the number or the compound frequency for 1 year, which is the number of blocks in 1 year. So in this case, our M is 4. So if you substitute the values in our equation, we will get a corresponding interest rate of 0.1255, or if we convert it into percentage value, it will be 12.55% for 1 year. So if you notice, if the nominal interest rate is 12%, the effective interest rate would be slightly higher, which is about 12.55% for 1 year. So you rasa bank suka yang mana? The nominal interest rate or the effective interest rate? Of course lah, effective interest rate, because dia akan memberikan lebih untung kepada mereka. So in the previous formula, the M represents the compound frequency for 1 year. So what if we want to measure the interest rate at any period? Instead of just 1 year, we want to measure at just any period. So for any period, you can use this information. The R in this equation represents the value of interest rate at one compound period. In this case, it would be 3%. The M in this case would be the compound frequency that we want to calculate. So in this case, our M would be 2. Let's look at this example. In this example, given that interest rate is 1.2% per month, they ask us to calculate the nominal and effective interest rate for 1 quarter. So let's just first draw the diagram across 1 year or 12 months. Okay, so you know, nampak je perkataan quarter ni, you have to divide the timeline into 4 equal region like this. Okay, so 1.2% per month is the interest rate given. So for nominal interest rate for 1 quarter, it can simply add on or multiply it with 3. Okay, so the nominal interest rate is 1.2%, multiply it with 3, you get 3.6% per quarter. So it's quite simple for nominal interest rate. But for effective interest rate, it's not as simple as that. You see, the first interest rate is 1.2%. The second, you have to add up another 1.2%, but instead of adding it up, it is being compounded. So every time the interests are being compounded, so you have to use the formula of effective interest rate. So in this case, we can use this formula. The R in this equation represents the interest rate for that 1 quarter or that 1 block. So the R would be 3.6%. The M is how many times it happens within that particular block. So in this case, our M is 3. So we substitute the value in our equation and we will get the effective interest rate to be 3.64% per quarter. So if you want to check whether your answer is correct or not, effective interest rate is usually slightly higher than the nominal interest rate. Here's another example. The interest rate still remains at 1.2% per month, but this time around, you have to calculate what is the nominal and effective interest rate for 1 year. Okay, again, let's draw the timeline up to 12 months or 1 year. So our block for the compound period would be for 12 months. And then we know that the interest rate is 1.2% for 1 month. Okay, nominal interest rate can simply be calculated by multiplying 1.2% sampai hujung tahun. Bloop, 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 bloop. So how many bloop, bloop are there? 12 bloops. So the nominal interest rate can be calculated by multiplying the interest rate of 1.2% with the total bloop, 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 which is 12. So you will get a value of 14.4% for 1 year. The effective interest rate in this case can simply be calculated again using the same formula. What is the R value? So remember, the R value would be the total interest for that whole 1 year, by which we already calculated in the nominal interest rate, which is 14.4%. Or if we put it in the formula, it will become 0.144. What is the M? How many bloop, 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 bloop are there? 12 bloop, bloop, bloop. So if you put it if you put all the value in the equation, you will get a value of 15.39% for 1 year. Okay, that is how you calculate the effective interest rate. Please follow up with the next episode of the video to see the real example of applying the effective interest rate in a case study.